Can your smartwatch really detect a heart attack? Can it tell if your heart rhythm is dangerous or just fast from your morning coffee? Today, I'm breaking down what your smartwatch can and can't tell you about your heart. The results may surprise you. If you're new here, I'm Hafiz, a cardiologist training in London. I started creating videos to increase awareness of heart disease so you can lead a healthier life. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, so you'll be the first to watch my videos when they come out. So let's start with what your smartwatch can actually do, especially when it comes to your heart health. First off, it's surprisingly good at tracking your heart rate. When you wear your smartwatch, it's constantly shining a light, usually green, onto your skin. You've probably seen it glow from the back of the device. That light is part of a technology called photoplethysmography, or PPG. Here's how it works. Every time your heart beats, blood is pumped through your wrist, and that blood absorbs light. So when your heart pumps, there's more blood and more light is absorbed. Between heartbeats, there's less blood and more light is reflected back. The watch uses a light sensor to detect these changes, literally tracking the rhythm of how the light bounces back, and from that, it calculates your heart rate in beats per minute. So in simple terms, your smartwatch is measuring how your blood flow changes with every heartbeat using light. Now, it's not perfect. If the watch is loose, if you're moving around a lot, or if you have darker tattoos in the area, the signal can be less accurate. But in general, for most people and most situations, it's pretty good, especially when you're still or at rest. Whether you're sitting on the sofa, going for a run, or recovering after a workout, your smartwatch keeps tabs on how your heart's behaving. That includes your resting heart rate, your heart rate during exercise, and how quickly it recovers afterwards, or useful data about your cardiovascular fitness. It can also measure your heart rate variability. Heart rate variability, or HRV, is the variation in time between each heartbeat, and it gives you an idea of how well your autonomic nervous system is functioning. Your smartwatch can also use heart rate data to estimate VO2 max, which is the maximum amount of oxygen your body can use during intense exercise, which is an indicator of cardiovascular fitness. Smartwatches can't measure VO2 max directly. That would require lab equipment. So they estimate it using heart rate data, GPS, and accelerometer data by detecting how fast and how far you're moving. It then personalizes your VO2 max according to your age, sex, height and weight. Some smartwatch models go even further by measuring your oxygen levels. It uses a technology called pulse oximetry, which is similar to what hospitals use, but in a much smaller wearable form. On the back of your watch, there are usually red and infrared lights along with light sensors. When these lights shine onto your wrist, they pass through your skin and your blood vessels. Oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood absorb light differently. Oxygen-rich blood absorbs more infrared light. Oxygen-poor blood absorbs more red light. The smartwatch's sensors detect how much light is reflected back, and by analyzing the ratio between the red and infrared light, the watch estimates your oxygen saturation level, or how much oxygen your blood is carrying. It's usually given as a percentage, something like 97% or 98% is normal for most people. If your levels drop too low, especially while sleeping or during illness, it could be a sign of a problem. That's why some people use this feature for things like tracking sleep apnea or monitoring their respiratory health. Many smartwatches now come with an ECG feature. ECG stands for electrocardiogram. It's a test that records the electrical signals your heart produces every time it beats. Now, in a hospital, you typically get a 12-lead ECG with multiple electrodes placed across your chest, arms, and legs to give a detailed view of your heart's rhythm from different angles. But your smartwatch uses a single-lead ECG. It's not as comprehensive as the 12-lead ECG you'd get in a clinic, but it can still pick up important things like irregular heart rhythms. Some devices go a step further and will even alert you if they detect an irregular rhythm like atrial fibrillation, which is the most common and often underdiagnosed heart rhythm disorder. I've done a whole video on AF and I'll link to it somewhere on the screen. Most smartwatches now offer sleep tracking, which can give you a rough breakdown of your sleep stages, light, deep, and REM, and help you understand your sleep patterns. The first thing your watch looks at is movement. Most smartwatches have a built-in accelerometer, which is a sensor that detects motion. When you lie still for long periods, especially at night, the watch assumes you're asleep. If you're tossing and turning, it can tell you're restless or possibly awake. The next layer is heart rate. Your heart rate drops when you sleep, especially during deep sleep. Your heart rate variability, the small changes in the time between beats, also shifts depending on your sleep stages. Smartwatches use this information to estimate when you're in light sleep, deep sleep, or REM sleep. Some watches also track breathing rate and blood oxygen levels during sleep. A drop in blood oxygen or irregular breathing patterns might indicate conditions like sleep apnea, although this is still a developing feature and not a medical diagnosis. More advanced models can track skin temperature and stress levels to build a more detailed picture of how well you're sleeping and recovering. Smartwatches are generally good at detecting when you fall asleep and wake up, and giving a general sense of sleep quality, but they're not perfect when it comes to exact sleep stages. So far, I've told you what your smartwatch can detect, but what can't your smartwatch detect? Currently, smartwatches cannot detect a heart attack. Heart attacks are caused by blocked arteries, not necessarily rhythm changes. You need a 12-lead ECG and blood tests such as troponin levels to diagnose a heart attack. Your watch may show a fast or irregular pulse, but it can't tell if you're having a heart attack. If you feel chest pain, don't rely on your smartwatch. Call emergency services. A clean ECG on your smartwatch doesn't rule out a heart attack. If you're using a smartwatch for health tracking, especially for your heart, here's how I recommend patients make the most of it. Firstly, focus on trends, not single numbers. One random heart rate reading or stress score doesn't tell the full story. But if you're seeing consistent changes over days or weeks, that's when it becomes useful and meaningful. Next, if you ever feel unwell, maybe palpitations, dizziness, or chest discomfort, make a note of it. Write down the time and check what your watch recorded around then. That context can be extremely helpful when trying to piece together what's going on. If your watch has an ECG feature, use it at the moment you feel symptoms. It won't catch everything, but if you're experiencing irregular heartbeats or fluttering, it might give us a clue, especially if you capture it in real time. Most smartwatches let you export the ECG or heart data as a PDF. Bring that to your GP, cardiologist, or healthcare provider. It's a great way to bridge the gap between what you feel and what we can see in clinic. And lastly, don't obsess over every metric. Things like stress scores, sleep data, or HRV will naturally fluctuate. One bad night of sleep doesn't mean your health is crashing. Look at the bigger picture and don't let the watch make you feel anxious. Use wisely, your smartwatch can be a powerful tool, but it's not a replacement for medical care. It's a helpful companion, especially when it comes to spotting patterns, tracking symptoms, and starting conversations with your doctor. So in summary, your smartwatch can help spot some rhythm issues like AF, and it gives powerful health trends, but it's not a replacement for clinical care. Use it as a health assistant tool, not your only doctor. So while smartwatches can be incredibly useful, especially when used wisely, they're not for everyone. If you're using one and it helps you feel more in control of your health, that's great. But if it's making you anxious or overwhelmed, you're not alone. Have you ever got a heart alert from your watch? Tell me your story in the comments below. If this video helped clear things up, hit like, share it with someone who's wearing a smartwatch. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.